Hello, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be focusing on ankles and ankle mobility. I just want to let you know that if you are interested in participating in full length yoga classes, I actually provide live classes as well as a virtual yoga membership, which is a monthly membership subscription. If you're interested in knowing more about that, just visit my website, tessarayyoga.com. So back to ankles, let's get started. You want to be sitting in a comfortable seated position. Generally, we can just have our legs out in front of us. I have these fun little toe separators on because I love them. Little side note about that, you can use like toe separators that you put on when you paint your toenails, or you can roll up Kleenex and put them in between your toes. It actually feels really nice on your feet and your ankles. So we've got our legs out in front of us. We can sit upright. We can lean back. We're paying attention to our ankles, and that's how we want it to be. So if you're feeling uncomfortable at all, you want to adjust, make yourself comfy. So we're going to start with simple, basic flex and point. And what we're looking for, which can definitely be unnatural at first, is leveling out your base of your big toe and base of your baby toe. So sometimes you'll notice as you flex, like maybe your pinky toe is further away or your big toe is further away. So think about keeping the inner edges of the feet parallel with one another as you flex and point. Keeping the big toe mound, baby toe mound level with one another as you flex and point. And now we're gonna point the toes and we're gonna go for some ankle circles. Here, I want you to focus on trying to keep your knees and your thighs still. So here we are really isolating the ankles. And if anyone out there is finding this easy, you wanna get more into flexibility of the ankles, try zipping the legs up and keeping the inner edges of the feet together. So that's going to be more challenging. Great big circles. And I think about reaching with all of my toes. So fourth toe, third toe. Some days I'm just like this toe I'm focusing on reaching with. And then we're going to go the other way. Connect with your breathing. So big breaths in through the nose, big breaths out through the nose. So deep breathing is very conducive to letting go of tension, creating new possibilities in your body physically. Okay, so now we're going to come to a flex. We're going to take our feet back to about a hip's width. We're going to go with the flex. We're going to go pinky toes out, big toes in. Pinky toes out, big toes in. Keep going like that. Another thing I love about these toe spreaders is that normally you would be really squeezing your toes together. And so this is just like keeping that space. If you find that your big toes are touching and it's restricting your range of motion, just take the heels a little wider. Normal for your ankles to fatigue here. Just take a break if you need to. Okay, now we're going to point the toes, and it's going to be the same. Pinky toes out, big toes in. Keep pointing the toes, pinky toes out, and big toes in. Sometimes when we first start yoga, especially if we're working on foot stuff, we get foot cramps. So if this is something that you're taking on, you want to increase your ankle mobility to prevent a repetitive injury or to help improve your balance or to help with knee pain. I would recommend increasing your daily water intake. And if you're drinking like two or more cups of coffee a day and you just keep getting so many foot cramps, consider drinking a little less coffee and a little more water. And also, randomly, bananas can help with foot cramps. My top tips of my yoga career. Okay, So now we're gonna flex again. It's a little more of a passive flex. You don't have to try so hard to flex. We're gonna go pinky edge of the feet away and then big toe edge of the foot away. Pinky edge away, big toe edge away. Or it's like the soles of your feet are facing one another and then the tops of the feet are facing one another. Keep going like that. And make sure that you're not pushing into any areas that are painful. Let this kind of mobility come to you over time. And the legs, they're gonna move around, it's all good, as this kind of mobility comes available to you, you can move the legs a little less. What matters most right now is that you're here and you're doing this, working on improving something that you want to improve on. Okay, so we're gonna come into, now we're gonna sit on our shins, and I wanna give you a few ideas about how to make this happen. So some of us can sit with our big toes together and sit down on our heels, no problem. So if that's you, just hang tight, squeeze those legs and push into the heels. Some alternatives, because sometimes the tops of your ankles, tops of your feet are really tight, or if you have knee pain in this position, some things that you can do are use a block or multiple blocks, place it between your heels, and that just gives you a little less pressure on the ankles and the knees, okay? And some of my students use like three blocks and sit up quite high. Okay, so that's one option. Another option, if it's all ankles, or for example, like I was working with an ankle injury last year, and so I still wanted to sit on my shins, but only one ankle was bothering me. So you can take a towel and roll up the towel and place the roll at the size of support that you need. So the bigger the roll, the more support it is. The smaller the roll, like sometimes I'll just roll up a sock and put it under my ankle. The smaller the roll, the less support. So you can just put that under the ankle and that actually can alleviate the discomfort or the level of sensation completely. So we're looking to manage our sensation so that there's no pain and we're at like an 8 out of 10 or even just like a 5 out of 10. So what feels appropriate for you? We're looking to improve from this practice and improve over time. Okay, so those of us using support, you're just looking to build endurance in this position, weight bearing on the tops of the feet. Some of us might be sitting on the tops of the ankles, no problem, and looking to go deeper. So if that's you, squeeze your thighs. So really zip up those legs, squeeze your bum a little bit too. You can lean back on your hands, scoop your bum under, and even see about lifting the knees up. I would not recommend this if sitting on your ankles is already a stretch. This is for people where sitting on the ankles is easy and you're looking for more intensity. So this goes right into the shins even. Some people might even be able to take the hands away. Okay, and then let's bring it down. So now we're gonna come forward and we're gonna do something else. So if you've got those props, you're gonna lose them. And now we're gonna tuck the toes under. And then we're gonna reach back and try to spread the toes, especially the fourth and fifth toe, do so carefully. And then I'm gonna inch my knees back and sit upright, if possible, on the heels. Now, this is kind of like torture for a lot of people. So if it's too intense, just come off of your heels. You can be upright with the toes tucked and you just kind of like work your endurance, your tolerance, maybe even enjoying it while you're in this position. So nice deep breaths. Drag your heels away from the backs of the knees. We're gonna come forward again and release the toes. Do so slowly, carefully, gently. We're gonna come back to the tops of the feet, and this is a little different than last time. So big toes and heels together if possible. And then we're gonna drag the heels back. So now there's an arch lift through the front of the ankle, front of the shin. And then we're just gonna work on keeping that strong so we can even come back and sit towards the heels again. So this is like a crazy workout for your foot and your ankle. So just, yeah, take it easy, no pain. If you have bunions or bones that are sticking into the floor, you might appreciate a blanket or something under your feet for padding. Some of you might be able to sit upright, no problem. And breathing. And coming forward, releasing your feet, bringing your knees to one side, hips to the other. We're gonna go back to where we started, swinging the legs in front of us. And we're gonna flex our feet, curl your toes, point your feet, and flip your toes back and spread your toes. So that's a flexed foot. Try to level out, big toe mound, baby toe mound. Curl your toes. Point your feet, flip your toes, flex, curl, point, and flip, flex, curl, point, and flip. Last thing here, we're gonna bring the feet together, and we're just gonna see if we can open the feet up like a book. So this particular pose is definitely working ankle flexibility, but it has much to do with your hips as well. So just do your best, see where you're at here. Try to spread the toes and spread the soles of the feet. Relax your shoulders. And relax your feet. So that's it for our ankle mobility practice today. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, I would so appreciate a thumbs up for my video. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do. I release videos every week. And if you subscribe, then you get a notification about that. Let me know in the comment section if there is anything that you'd like to see me release in the future. Thank you so much for joining me today and for allowing me to share my practice with you. Namaste.